All right, folks, God bless you. Welcome to This Is It Before the Fire. It's coming, guys. Okay, today's video is going to be just, I cannot wait to give you today's video. So let's get started. We're going to have several venues today. I'm going to give you some scripture. I'm going to show you the mystery of everything, the existence of God, the existence of the Most High God, proof. Using the scriptures. I always come with the scriptures. This is what the Lord showed me. So let me ask you this. What if your existence, all of our existence, in our host body, in our bodies, was clearly defined and clearly very easily to see? However, it was just a matter of the Lord God revealing it because the time had come for everyone to understand the system that you live in and the mystery of all things to be revealed. The Bible says, in the end, everything that's secret will be made public. That which is hidden in darkness shall be brought to the light. Isn't it odd? Come out of the darkness into the light with glad eyewear. You want to see something just amazing? Let's look at the scriptures first. Y'all remember the Adidas original commercial where they're all hanging upside down? Everybody, five people hanging upside down with X's on their chest. The guy in the middle is half black, half white. His color, his clothing, half black, half white. And they're playing a song called I Did It My Way. You know, like Frank Sinatra. Everlasting chains of darkness, forward and backwards, ligaments of the body, Jude. It's interesting that they have their hair. Is that a pitchfork or is that a double U? Or isn't it interesting that the devil holds a pitchfork and it makes a double U? They both have double U's on their heads, don't they, facing opposite directions? They do. But let's look how it starts. This is called Adidas original is never finished, right there. Now, let's look at the Bible. Woe unto those who go to great depths to hide their plans from the Lord, who do their work in darkness and think, who sees us? Who will know? You turn things upside down as if the potter were thought to be like the clay. Okay, that is right there. You're looking at the NIV version. I just did it to make it simple for a lot of people, but I'm going to go ahead and change it to the KJV because I don't do the NIV because that's not the way the Lord told me to understand the Bible. He taught me to read it in KJV and then go to the concordance and break down every word to its original language, which is what I do. So watch this. For the Lord has poured out upon you the spirit of deep sleep. See it right there? The Bible says also in Ephesians, arise, O sleeper, awake. Arise, O sleeper, wake up from the dead. The spirit of deep sleep, and he has closed your eyes, the prophets and your rulers and the seers he has covered. And the vision of all has become unto you as the words of a book that is sealed. Okay, now look right here. Woe unto them that seek deep to hide their counsel from the Lord, and their works are in the dark. And they say, who seeth us? Who knoweth us? Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay. I already showed you that in Genesis 2, when the Lord God, not Elohim, not God Elohim, but the Lord God, the self-existent eternal Jehovah, formed Adam as a potter from the dust, clay, potter's clay. So surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay, because see, we got carried away captive into their system. Now watch, I'm going to show you how this is manifest all around you. And then during this video, I'm going to show you how the Lord God, the King of Kings, is proving to you that the finish is coming right away. And he did it in a way that we can juxtaposition it with the way Elohim, the divining serpent, does their little, you know, prognostications. What they do is, like, they printed the bombings of the Twin Towers on the U.S. currency. They printed the bombing of the federal building on the U.S. currency before it ever happened. They already had the bombings printed on the money. That means that the serpent that's running this host body system, like a big queen ant from the pit, is making things happen according to her will. The angel of the bottomless pit is Satan, but it's a female mother goddess system, the woman that rides the beast. Come out of her, my people, for her sins are piled as high as heaven, and the time of her judgment has come. Now watch. Watch this. This is okay, so wouldn't it be amazing? Wouldn't it just be a mind blower if the most profound truth was as simple as turning everything upside down to understand everything? By the way, that's the rock that Jesus is talking about in Matthew 16. Upon this rock, I will build my church. That's what he's talking about. Watch. So here we go. Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as a potter's clay, right there. So let me show you a little clip from a movie called National Treasure. And then I'm just going to play this whole 3:12 video all the way through. Ready? And this is from a video I've already done, but just watch this.
Really be that simple? The secret lies with Charlotte.
Okay, this is the movie National Treasure. Now watch, just like I'm showing you in all these other videos, the names in all these movies, all these commercials, names are significant and the idea is significant. Watch and listen to what he says.
Could it really be that simple?
Could it really be that simple? That pipe represents the kingdom.
The secret lies with Charlotte.
The secret lies with Charlotte. There's everything. Could it really be that simple? The secret lies with Charlotte. So that, see, the pipe has the kingdom on it. And then he puts the pipe stem in, representing a phallic symbol. Now watch, he turns it upside down. Could it really be that simple? Turns it 180 degrees the opposite direction of the phallic symbol. Okay, there you go. I'm going to pause that right there. And then, if you watch the movie, the door opens and the greatest treasure you could ever imagine is behind that door. Well, the greatest treasure you could ever get is your own soul. What should it profit a man if he gained the whole world and lose his soul? So, I'm gonna give you the greatest treasure you could ever have, just as simply as that. The night I got saved, remember I told you, Lord told me, read the tags and the shirts I was carrying. A blanket of energy descended upon me. This is in my personal testimony. The Lord told me I had to do it. I said it was like an invisible blanket of energy just enveloping me, like it was all around me and through me at the same time. It's in my testimony. Wait till you see what the definition of Christ is. Just get ready. So, he turns it upside down and he says, could it really be that simple? The secret lies with Charlotte. Charlotte is a female given name, a female form of the name Charles. It is of French origin, meaning free man. Okay, so Charlotte is a female given name, but it comes from Charles. But Charlotte means free man. So it's a female name. Female. that means free man. That's kind of interesting, right? Well, I'm going to show you a little picture here real quick. Remember the tree of the knowledge of good and evil? He said, neither shall you touch it lest you die. The word touch in Genesis 3, and I think everything I tell you, I think I should just prove it real quick, because we will go to Ephesians in just a minute. But let's go to Genesis 3. Neither shall you touch it lest you die, to lie with a woman. There you go. Now I'm going to go back to Ephesians, because we'll be in Ephesians in just a minute. Ephesians 5. Okay, and then I'll drop that down. Now, Charlotte is a female given name, a female form of the name Charles. It means free man. And then this guy says, could it really be that simple? Okay, this is the movie National Treasure. Now watch, just like I'm showing you in all these other videos, the names in all these movies, all these commercials, names are significant and the idea is significant. Watch and listen to what he says. Can it really be that simple? That pipe represents the kingdom. The secret lies with Charlotte. There's everything. Could it really be that simple? The secret lies with Charlotte. So that, see, the pipe has the kingdom on it. And then he puts the pipe stem in, representing a phallic symbol. Now watch, he turns it upside down. Could it really be that simple? Turns it 180 degrees the opposite direction. Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay. Potter's clay is what the Lord God formed in Genesis 2 when he named Adam as Christ's representative in the system. Okay. Charlotte means a free man. Up, down. Ana means up. In Greek, kata means down. Jesus up, Satan down. Light up, dark down. Good up, evil down. Now, let me show you the system that you're in. Okay, so I do a little thing for you so you can see it. So I should have. So if you're male energy, you have two arrows that should be pointing up, like both your eyes. So you, there's two ups. If you're the female energy, you have two downs. And in the middle where the two intersect, you have an up and a down. So that is the system that you're caught in. You have one good eye and one male, one female energy that have intersected, everlasting chains of darkness, the double-headed phoenix, the Adidas commercial, the two girls facing opposite directions, the original hanging upside down, because the original is upside down. But when you breed the original two upside down and you have the right side up, so you have two ups and then the downs, and in the middle when you cross it to, you get an up and a down in the same system, which is your body. And in order to make it that simple, you turn one up and the female turns to a free man, male energy, all male energy. That's why Jesus was a man. That's why we have all this gender, weird identification, gender confusion going on this planet. Watch. So he turns it upside down. Charlotte means free man. So he turns Charlotte, which is a pipe that he has in that movie. The name of the pipe is Charlotte, and it's a meerschaum pipe, which is, by the way, sea foam. Meerschaum is made from sea foam, which is also, it's also euphemistic for semen. And he puts it in and he turns it upside down, and Charlotte becomes a free man. And you get the greatest treasure there is. Now, let me write down a number real quick. What number is that? 1-6. 1-6. Well, if I were to rotate that 1-6 and I was to make it upside down and backwards, it would be a 9-1, wouldn't it? So if I was to take a 1-6 and put it into this system that's upside, make it a 9-1. So the exact opposite of a 1-6 would be a 9-1. 1-6-9-1 would be, so a 1-6 upside down and backwards would be a 9-1. Y'all ready for some biblical understanding that's going to smoke your entire brain? Buckle up, because here we go. Ready? Okay, now, here's a little caveat for a lot of people that haven't been doing this as long as I have. Because some people freak out. They're like, oh, wait a minute, it doesn't add up. Everything always adds up perfectly when you understand how to read it and when you understand the context of what you're reading. It's perfect. It's literally perfection. So let me show you something. So here we go. And Moses kept the flock of Jethro, his father-in-law, and the priest of Midian, and led the flock the backside to the backside of the desert. Interesting word, backside of the hind part of the desert, and came to the mountain of God. Well, everyone's like, oh my gosh, Elohim. Yep. And the angel of the Lord. So the angel, the messenger, a messenger specifically of God, that is an angel of the Lord, ambassador, angel, king, messenger of the Lord, the self-existent, eternal Jehovah, appeared unto him in a flame of fire out of the midst of a bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire, and the bush was not consumed. And when he turned, and when the Lord saw that he had turned aside to see, God called unto him. Now everyone's like, oh my God, it says Elohim. Correct. But you have to realize, even the word Lord God says the self-existing eternal Jehovah Elohim. It's also generically a name for God. Watch. And when the Lord saw that he had turned aside to see, God called out to from the midst of the bush. So who's talking to him here? The Lord? And when the Lord saw that he had turned aside to see, God called him, called unto him from the midst of the bush. He said, Moses, Moses. And he said, here am I. He said, draw not nigh hither, put off thy shoes from thy feet, for the place whereon thou standest is holy ground. I think that's very interesting, because when you look at like the fact that we actually have a pair of shoes on, you know, like YG, the shoes, bait, host body, slave system. The word body means slave. The word body means slave. That's what it means. I'll show it to you in a minute. So take off thy shoes. This is holy ground. And the Lord said, surely I have seen the affliction of my people in Egypt. And he's going to bring him out. And look, I am come down. So I am is coming down into the system. Yarad, to descend, literally to go downwards to a lower region as the shore, a boundary of the enemy, literally or figuratively to fall. I am come down, cast down, to cause to come down. Let me show you a picture again real quick. So if you have two ups and you have the two downs and you come together and you have an up and a down in the same system, a host. I'm not talking about the Lord God. I'm talking about our host body system. We have an eye that's up and an eye that's down. You have good and evil. Good is up, evil's down. Light is up, dark is down. God is up, Satan's down. You getting this? If your eye is single, your whole body is full of light. Because light is up, dark is down. If your eye becomes single, both eyes are light. That's why even in that same scripture, if the light in you be darkness, how great is the darkness? Now watch. I am come down to deliver and bring them out of the hand of the Egyptians and out of and into a land flowing with milk and honey. Now watch, I'm going to show you something real quick, just so everybody doesn't like have a panic attack. Genesis 2. And the Lord God, see the Lord right in front of the word God, the self-existent eternal Jehovah Elohim. So it's when you put that and you're using Lord, Lord God, self-existent eternal Jehovah Elohim, it's different. It's in the system. So you have a back and forth going between the Lord God and God, but God can also be used generically to talk about the Lord God in that particular scripture. Now watch. Here we go. Exodus 3. Ready? So, and the Lord saw Moses turned aside, and then the Lord said, I have seen the suffering of my people. And he said, I am come down. I am come down to descend, to deliver, to snatch away, to defend, to deliver, to escape, to bring them up, oh my gosh, to ascend. So what's he doing? He said, I'm coming down to bring them up out of the land of Egypt. Now remember this, the whole earth is Egypt. Now watch this. And so, and Moses is worried about, well, who do I tell him sent me? When I show up and I say, God, you know, God has sent me to you guys, who do I tell him you are? And God said unto, and Moses said unto God, behold, when I come unto the children of Israel and say unto them, the Elohim of your fathers has sent me unto you, and they shall say to me, what is his name? And what do I say to them? And God said unto Moses, I am that I am. Watch it, folks. What is the number? Where'd it go? Exodus 3. He says unto Moses, I'm going to bring them up, and you tell them that I am that I am said, I'm coming, I'm here. What is I am? Isn't that perfect? 1961. I am that I am to exist. And you tell them that I am is coming for them to bring them up out of the land of Egypt. I'll show you again. And it says, and God said moreover unto Moses, thus thou shalt say unto the children of Israel, the Lord God, the self-existent eternal Jehovah Elohim of your fathers, the Elohim of Abraham, the Elohim of Isaac, and the Elohim of Jacob, has sent me unto you. This is my name forever, and this is my memorial unto all generations. And then he said, go and gather the elders of Israel and together and say to them, the Lord God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, appeared unto me, saying, surely I have visited you and seen that which is done to you in Egypt. Look, Asah. That's the same word as let us make man in our vain show. Done to you in Egypt. And I will bring you up to ascend. Now this is a foreshadowing of Christ, that he's going to come into the system where we're trapped in that condition where there's red is up, blue is down, scorpions are blue bloods. The red represents God, the Lord God's blood, Adam in the system. That's why Adam literally means to show blood, red. Okay, and then when you get converted, there you are. You got eyes that are single. You're no longer eyes that are double, one up, one down. Told you. It's even in Exodus. So, now everything is making sense. So, the angels that wanted host bodies, You got put in the right side up, upside down system. That's why you got to get converted, because you have male energy and female energy, and they are in opposition to each other. So when you get converted and you accept Jesus Christ, a male, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, anyone that's teaching the Holy Spirit is female, is an apostate. I love you, Zen, but you're wrong, buddy. It's terrible what's happened. Anyway, so the male energy is what converts you to back to the Lord God. That's why it says, I will bring you up to ascend. Now we are going to go into the Bible some more. So that's why Charlotte is a female given name from the name Charlotte, Charlotte, a diminutive of Charles, and it means a free man. So see, in the movie National Treasure, right here, that's why the greatest treasure you can get, watch.
Okay, this is the movie now.
There you go. Now, I'm going to show you how the serpent from the pit. Okay, well, the serpent race is the entire host body system that's in this condition. That's in that condition right there. See that? That condition right there? That's the serpent. That's the condition that the serpent from the pit is controlling everybody, because there's an angel and a demon in every host body. Angels up, demons down. So, well, but in this system, we get flipped. So we got to get flipped right back. The other eyes got to be flipped up. That's why the night I got saved, when I said this blanket of energy like descended on me, and I was like, what is this? It's in my personal testimony. The Lord told me I had to do it. I didn't want to do it. I was like, Gary, why is it going to be so freaking mean? And the Lord, I was right. There are so many people that were like psychopathically hostile towards me for posting my personal testimony. And the Lord told me I had to. So anyway, so I said this blanket of energy descended upon me. And I was like, what is this? And I looked at Lou and I said, some source is telling me to read the tags on the clothes I'm carrying. And I read that first tag. It said 100% nylon. And I was like, that doesn't make any sense. And then I heard, then I was looking at the tag and I went 100% trying to figure it out. And I heard the Lord say, turn it upside down. So I turned it upside down and I read nylon upside down and backwards. You know, like 1961. I exist. It just, wait, it's going to get even better. I was like, what? Yeah. So here we go. Hang on one sec. Okay. So before I switch scriptures on you, now remember what he said. I am come down to deliver, to snatch away, to defend, to deliver. Because this is about what's going to happen to us real quick. To pluck, to recover, to rescue. I am come down to deliver and bring them up to ascend. That's what's about to happen to the church. I'm the guy. I'm the bell ringer. Okay, and then he says, so you can go tell them that I am that I am came to you. I'm going to color this. I'm going to color 19. I'll color that one that color, and then I'll color 6-1 a different color, because it's just a reversal. 1961 has come down. I mean, this is perfection, guys. Now get ready. Now let me show you something. Let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 2. Okay, here we go. Now, see, when I told you again, when I got converted, it was like it was a blanket of energy descended upon me. It's in my testimony. When I was in that hotel room, this blanket of invisible energy just like descended. And I was like looking at my arms going, what is this? My hair was standing straight up. And I was just like, you know, it was so wild. I was just like, what's going on? What is this? So I'm looking at my mic, making sure I did an hour and a half video for y'all last night and the mic switched off. So I'm redoing it. So anyway, so this blank of energy descends on me, tells me to read the tags on the clothes I'm carrying. 100% nylon. That doesn't make any sense. It tells me turn it upside down. 100% no lying. You know, like a Texan saying, don't you be lying to me, boy. Yeah, no lying. 100% no lying. That's 100% truth, because truth is absolute. It is completely opposite to a lie. Either you have 100% truth or you don't have truth at all. There's no 99% truth. It's either 100% or it's not the truth. That's why there's the truth and then there's everything else. Now, watch this. Here we go. So this is what the Lord showed me. So here's Paul talking, and my speech and my preaching was not with enticing words of man's wisdom, because this is what they have when you go to almost every church I've been to, is they teach man's wisdom. That's not what I teach. And he said, but in the demonstration of the Spirit. Now look at the word Spirit. It's capital S. Now the word Spirit, the word is pneuma. I'm going to change the color to yellow. See, pneuma, like pneumonia, means current of air. That is breath. It means superhuman, an angel, comma, demon. I'm going to change that color. An angel, comma, demon. I'm going to change it to green. And superhuman, an angel, demon, or I'm going to change that to yellow so you can see it's or divine, God, Christ, Spirit. So you have to be born again, because you're what? You're a superhuman angel demon, right side up, upside down. So you have to be born again and get converted to that. So your eyes become single. Well, how do you get converted? If you're trapped in, see that blue and the red arrow? That's your superhuman angel demon spirit that's running you. But then when you get converted, you got turned upside down and you become Christ's Holy Spirit, and your eyes become single, and you can see everything like Jonathan Kleck. I can see everything, guys. So watch. So it says, but his preaching was in demonstration of the Spirit and of power, miraculous power. I come with miraculous power too, guys. The Lord has gifted me in miraculous power. And it says that your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men. Look at this. That your faith, look at the word faith, moral conviction of religious truth, the truthfulness of God or a religious teacher. I'm going to change that color to this. Okay. Especially reliance upon Christ for salvation. I'm going to change that to yellow. There it is. The gospel truth itself, so that your faith, the gospel truth itself, should not stand in the wisdom of men. Brace yourself, stand. It means might, can, could, would, must, and it is 15:10. I exist. I am. Because to stand, you get turned up. I will bring you up out of the land of Egypt to stand. That's why the word stand right here is that your faith, the truth, the gospel truth, should not stand in the wisdom of men. Stand. I exist right there. And so it says, howbeit we speak wisdom among them that are perfect, yet not the wisdom of this world, properly an age. Now watch this. But we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, even the hidden wisdom, it means to conceal away that is fully concealed. Even a hidden wisdom, which God ordained before the world. Okay, now watch this. Now we get down here. Hang on one sec. I want to make sure I put in kind. Now we have not received the spirit of the world. Look at the spirit of the world. See right here? Spirit of the world right here. I'm going to highlight all that. Uh-oh. We have not received the spirit of the world. Okay, I'm going to highlight that. But right here, see the word spirit? I'm going to change that to yellow. We have not received the spirit. See, it's little s. It's the same number, 4151. See? Pneuma, current of air, superhuman angel demon. That is the spirit of the world, the superhuman angel demon. But when you get born again, instead of an angel and a demon in opposition to each other, your bodies become single because you get born again from above. I told you. Now watch. So watch this. Now we have not received the spirit of the world, orderly, the cosmos, orderly arrangement, decoration. That's perfect. But the spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us from God. Properly to see, literally or figuratively, to be aware of, to perceive, and to understand. That we might know these things that are freely given to us from God. Which things we also speak not in words which man's wisdom teaches, but which the Holy Ghost. See right there? Holy Ghost, watch. It's pneuma, superhuman angel demon. No, Christ's Holy Spirit. See the Holy Ghost? The word Holy Ghost is the same word as spirit. Holy means ceremonially consecrated, physically or morally pure and blameless, and then ghost. So we're blameless because we got a new spirit. We went from superhuman and angel demon to God, Christ, Holy Spirit. See? Which the Holy Ghost teacheth, instructs, communicates concerning spiritual things with spiritual. But here we go. Here's all the haters. But the natural man receiveth not the things of, look at the word spirit right here. It's capital. The spirit of God. What word is it? It's pneuma, 4151. The same as the word ghost for Holy Ghost. Watch. Let's see. Here we go. I'll do Holy Ghost right here in yellow. Let me do that. There you go. See, Holy Ghost. Holy, morally. Watch this. Holy, morally blameless, pure, consecrated. It also says saint, Holy Ghost. The word ghost is 4151, and the word is pneuma. You should always say the word in its original language. Pneuma. Divine, God, Christ, Holy Spirit. Right there. Divine, God, Christ, Spirit. The Holy Spirit. So here we go. Now here we go. But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit, the Holy Spirit. The natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, that's the Holy Spirit, for they are foolishness unto him, neither can he know them, to know absolutely. See, here's the thing. This is where the churches have screwed everybody. They're like, oh, just raise your hand if you met Jesus today. And then all these people think they're saved because they raised their hands and they got a Bible, but they never got flipped. Could it really be that simple? The secret lies with Charlotte. I told you. It's like, you flip that female energy in your system, and instead of having female and male opposing energies, you flip it and you have one energy, the Holy Spirit. No more superhuman angel demon fighting. You got just the angel. Told you. So here we go. But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him, neither can he know them to know absolutely, because they are spiritually, divinely discerned. See that word discerned? Anakrino. Scrutinized. Now watch this. Now this is, I'm gonna do the expanded version of this. Here we go. Hang on one sec. I got a little bit of a cord problem. Okay, here we go. Watch this. Strong's 350. Strong's 350. Anakrino. There we go. Here it is. Anakrino. See? They're spiritually discerned, to examine, to investigate. It means, ana means up, just like in Exodus, I will bring them up out of the land of Egypt. Up, ana, completing a process. The process that's getting completed is you. You're getting completed, turned up. Ana krino. Krino, to select by separating and judging. What do you think the separation is that happens between the sheep and the goats when Jesus comes? If you haven't been turned up, you're in deep, deep trouble. Oh yeah, that's what the judgment is. That is your judgment. You weren't turned up, you're done. You're down. You're kata. You're darkness. You're evil. Down is judged. Up, two ups, is not judged. Up and down at the same time, you still have a chance. Two downs, you're done. Got it? Watch this. Ana krino. Look what it means. Properly to distinguish. Look, properly to distinguish by vigorously judging down to up. Okay, here's a good time for this. Oh, there you go. Remember Jonathan Kleck showing you the dead sheep so many times? Vigorously judging down to up. Well, see, they're selling this to you as the virgin, because that other race, the originals, that, you know, the daughters of men, the sons of God saw the daughters of men were fair. So, yep, there you go. See, there's the virgin, and you turn the virgin upside down, and it's a dead sheep. Who are the dead sheep? Well, hello. Remember the keto commercial? God's royalty, his princes are the sheep. Well, hello. You know, that's so funny. You got to give it to them. They really know how to mock us. So there's a virgin. So I'm going to vigorously judge this from down to up. So when I turn this the right way, I see the truth. The virgin equals a dead sheep. Oh, wow. That's crazy. So here we go. Now let's go back to the Bible. I told you it's going to be a Bible lesson. Then we got some really good stuff. So, but the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness to him, because neither can he know them. He cannot know them absolutely, because they are spiritually discerned, anakrino, to vigorously judge. Judging down to up, the process of careful study, evaluation, and judgment. And that's what I've been doing for a long time. Okay, now that you guys have got a Bible lesson, let me go back to the Bible. The Bible says in Ephesians 5:14, wherefore he saith, awake thou that sleepest, because just like me, hang on one second, I have a little bit of a problem here. Okay, here we go, hang on one sec. Wherefore he saith, awake thou that sleepest. Awake, ready? Through the idea of collecting one's faculties to waken. So, in the scripture where it says, awake thou that sleepest, look, awake. Capital, look, awake. Awake, it's capital. There's not a period there, there's a comma. Awake. It means through the idea of collecting one's faculties to waken, to rouse, literally from sleep or from disease or death. Look what it says, to lift up. I'm going to change this color to blue. I'm going to do it in front of you. Okay. So to lift up, to raise up, to rear up, to rise up, to take up. Told you. So awake, thou that sleepest. Ready? Sleepest. Preposition. Down in place. Kata. I told you. Kata. Down in place. And see Led Zeppelin holding the Z and the P, 2616. Kata dynasteo. Yeah? You getting this? It's all about this. Told you. The mystery of everything. I exist. 1961. Told you. The very existence of the Lord God is proven. So, awake thou that sleepest. Look, sleepest, thou that is in the down position. Why do you think all of Islam plays with their heads on the ground? They're praying, they're bowing to the pit, they're putting their head down to the pit. We, with the word prayer and supplication, when a slave used to come before the king back in the day, you know, they would come in with their hands up like this, they would come in and they would palms up. The night I got saved, Michael stepped up and he said, pray with me, my brother, hands up. And we had our hands up praying to the sky. We pray up, they pray down. Why do you think in churches they tell everybody bow your head? They're tricking you. Bow your head. Head in a downward position. The Bible says anyone who prays with their head covered dishonored their own head. And Christ is the head of the church. Watch this. Now I'm just going to go on a scripture rampage right now. Anyone who prays with... with their head covered, First Corinthians 11:15. Hang on, here we go. Ready? First Corinthians 11:15. First Corinthians 11:15. Ready? Here we go. Watch. 1 Corinthians 11:15. Watch this. Every man praying or prophesying with his head covered dishonoreth his own head. Watch this. Covered. Kata. Down in place. Told ya. That's why they get you in these churches and say, bow your head. You're dishonoring Christ when you do it. I told ya. It's all about up and down. Let me show you that little thing I got again. So, up, down. Anakata. Jesus, Satan. Light, dark. Good, evil. And that's, see, so when you have it, all those in one thing, picture, you know, those in one body. Well, when you flip it, you're good. You're converted. That's what it means. So there you go. So every man that prayed or prophesying with his head covered, dishonored his own head down in place. Now let's go back. You know what? Let's go back to Ephesians real quick. Go back to Ephesians because now I can just jump all over the Bible and prove it left and right all day long now. Okay, here we go. Awake to rouse for... to collect one's faculties, to waken, to lift up, to raise up, to rear up, to rise up again, to take up. Okay, thou that sleepest, who's in a downward position? Because you're down in position. You got to get your head up. Okay, now, let's see. When Jesus comes, Mark 13, right? We're not supposed to. We're supposed to be watching. We're supposed to be ready. Mark 13. The end of the age. No one knows the hour of the day. A lot of people say, Kleck, you're trying to say you know the hour of the day. No, I'm not. I'm trying to tell you I know that it's coming. Jesus is coming. I'm a bell ringer. I'm like John the Baptist. The king is coming. It's like he's coming. How do I know? Look at everything I'm showing you. There's a church out there and a bell. It's like, come on. So anyway, so here we go. Okay, so watch therefore, because you know not when the master of the house cometh. At even, isn't that interesting? At even, look at that word, even. It's interesting, it's not populating. At even, through the idea of backwardsness, interesting. Through the idea of backwardsness, sorry, don't want to get off on a tangent, or at midnight, or at the cock crowing, or at the morning. Here it is, guys. Lest coming suddenly, so out of nowhere, all of a sudden, unexpectedly, he finds you sleeping, kata, in a downward position. Get it? So if he comes suddenly and you're like that, you're in trouble. You're going to get to see all the horror that's coming. Told you. Arise, O sleeper. Sleeper. Downward position. Wake up. Get turned up from the dead. The dead is down. Life is up. Dead is down. Because you're in their system. The earth is their little system party. The host body system, no, no. No host bodies. The host body is an idol. And so we're not supposed to make idols. Anyone doesn't believe me? Genesis 1, I'll do it again. And here it is. And Elohim said, let us make. Remember, asah, to do or to make. Man, what's the word for man? I like saying Adam, C-D-A-W-M, Adam. It's Hebrew word 120. It's not 121, which is Adam. A human being hypocrite. Let us make a hypocrite in our image. What's the word for image? A phantom. So a human being is really a phantom. It's figuratively an illusion. So it's really an illusion. And here it is. It's a resemblance, hence a representative figure, especially an idol. So you know that the Lord God hates idols. So Elohim created man in his own image. In the vain show, see, the vain show, representative figure, especially an idol. In the vain show, representative figure, especially an idol of Elohim, created he him. That's Lucifer. And the cumulative sum of the angels that wanted to do it, male and female. Male and female created he them. So see, the greatest illusion of everything is male-female. It's just like a male host body and a female host body. It's a phantom image. It's an illusion. It's a trap is what it is. It's a trap. Now watch this. Let's prove that out. Exodus 20. I am the Lord thy God. See, I am the Lord thy God. I am the Lord thy God, which brought thee out of the land of Egypt, the house of bondage, slavery. See, a slavery. Thou shalt have no other gods, Elohim, before me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of any things in the heavens, the earth, or the water under the earth. Look. Any likeness, what does it say? It says something portioned right there that is fashioned out as a shape that is indefinitely, see it right there, phantom, specifically embodiment. Oh my God, embodiment, specifically embodiment. So thou shalt not make a phantom, specifically embodiment. And you did it. You were willing to do it. So you got it. Now it's got to be redeemed. Because when you did it, you go into a system where you get one up, one down, male, female, they're opposite, everlasting chains of darkness, and that's it. And unless you get converted, turned up, you go to the pit. and you become food for a race of locusts. My entire life bears witness to this. My entire life. My name, Yahweh is given, Jonathan Kleck, a messenger that rings a bell, gathers a church, town crier. What's town crier to? He goes through a town, rings a bell, makes a lot of noise on behalf of the king. Tells everybody what the king's telling you. What do you think I'm doing? I was sent by the king. I was awakened in my host body. Arise, O sleeper, wake up from the dead, and Christ will give you light. Ready? Remember my testimony? I said it was like an invisible blanket of energy that was just all around me at the same time. You know, kind of like a hummingbird or a butterfly, just like, what? My whole body was buzzing like crazy. Let's go back to Ephesians. By the way, if you make an idol, look what it says. Thou shalt, look, you shall not make any likeness of anything. Look, any likeness, something portion, specifically embodiment. For thou shalt not bow down to them, nor serve them, to till, like till the soil, keep in bondage. Serve them, because I, the Lord thy God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children unto the third and fourth generations of them that hate me, to personally hate. They hate Jesus. They hate the Lord God. They hate him. And the proof that they hate him is they made a host body system. Told you. It's the greatest illusion of all time, man. It's amazing. This is just absolutely staggering. Okay, back to Ephesians. Ready? Ephesians. Johnny's going to show you something that happened to Johnny. Ephesians 5:14. Awake, awake to stand up, thou that sleepeth. Awake, lift up, stand up, raise up, rise up again, take up. Thou that sleepest in the down position, kata. Thou that's in the down position, arise, stand up to raise up again from the root word. What? What's the root? Anna, up. I told you, rise, arise from the dead, literally. And Christ shall give thee light. Ready? Look at the word Christ. Ready? Christ, the anointed, that is the Messiah. Through the idea of contact, to rub, let's see, hang on, doom, to light upon. Told you. To furnish what is needed, to light upon. There it is. See it? To light upon. That's exactly what happened to me the night I got saved. Then in the alley, I was anointed from above. Yeah. Told you. Coach Miles Prophet. No. Uh-huh. There it is. So look at how the scriptures are unfolding before your very eyes. Now, let me show you guys. So let me knock that down. Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay. Let me show you real quick. Since I'm doing a scriptural thing, let me just knock this out of the park real quick. Genesis 1 is they're going to form man. So they're not going to form. They're going to make man. Watch. Let us make. Look at the word. Asah. To do or to make. To appoint. Man. A hypocrite. A human being hypocrite in our vain show, resemblance, especially an idol. So they made male and female. Now look here in Genesis 2, and the Lord God, see, and the Lord God right here, the Lord God, I'm going to change that all to blue, and the Lord God formed man. So here's another formation of man, because he's going to come down to make. This is Christ's representative in the system. Watch. And the Lord God formed. See the word formed? 33:35. You know what? I'm going to change the color here. I'm going to change that color to that to keep it all the same. So the Lord God formed Yatsar. See it? Yatsar. Through the idea of squeezing into shape, especially as a potter. Man from the dust, and the word dust is clay. I'm going to change that color too. So the Lord God formed his man. So the Lord God's forming his version of man from the clay, and that's the potter's clay. See? Formed. Potter. Dust. Clay. The Lord God's man is the potter's clay. So then he says, okay, and then he's going to, then he breathes into him, and he breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. I'm going to change that color right there to just yellow. So, and he breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. So here's where the breath of life, and man became a living soul. See it? So the one in Genesis 1 is, there's no living soul there. They're soul capturers because they're attached to the pit. And then they've set the bait trap. God's angels come in, and then you get the system. Get it? I told you. All right. So there you go. So the Lord God formed man from the dust of the ground. Now watch this. Back to, hang on one sec. Sorry, I'm getting this thing is a little stuck. Sorry, having a little bit of a glitch. Okay, now watch this. So here's in Isaiah 29. Therefore, now watch this. I'm going to read all this to you. You guys got to understand. This is the scripture the Lord used. So, wow, this whole, you know what? Let's have Max McLean read it. Let's have Max read it. Okay, here we go. Let's do Max.
Isaiah 29. Woe to Ariel. To Ariel, the city where David dwelt. Add ye year to year. Let them kill sacrifices. Yet I will distress Ariel, and there shall be heaviness and sorrow.
We are Ariel.
And it shall be unto me as Ariel. And I will camp against thee round about, and will lay siege against thee with a mount. And I will raise forts against thee, and thou shalt be brought down, and shalt speak out of the ground. And thy speech shall be low out of the dust, and thy voice shall be as a one that hath a familiar spirit out of the ground, and thy speech shall whisper out of the dust. Moreover, the multitude of thy strangers shall be like small dust, and the multitude of the terrible ones shall be as chaff that passeth away, yea, it shall be at an instant suddenly. Thou shalt be visited of the Lord of hosts with thunder, and with earthquake, and great noise, with storm and tempest, and the flame of devouring fire. And the multitude of all the nations that fight against Ariel, even all that fight against her and her munition, and that distress her, shall be as a dream of a night vision. It shall even be as when a hungry man dreameth, and behold, he eateth, but he awaketh, and his soul is empty, or as when a thirsty man dreameth, and behold, he drinketh, but he awaketh, and behold, he is faint, and his soul hath appetite. So shall the multitude of all the nations be that fight against Mount Zion. Stay yourselves and wonder, cry ye out and cry. They are drunken, but not with wine, they stagger, but not with strong drink. For the Lord hath poured out upon you the spirit of deep sleep, and hath closed your eyes. The prophets and your rulers, the seers, hath he covered. And the vision of all is become unto you as the words of a book that is sealed, which men deliver to one that is learned, saying, Read this, I pray thee. And he saith, I cannot, for it is sealed. And the book is delivered to him that is not learned, saying, Read this, I pray thee. And he saith, I am not learned. Wherefore the Lord said, Forasmuch as this people draw near me with their mouth, and with their lips do honor me, but have removed their heart far from me, and their fear toward me is taught by the precept of men. Therefore, behold, I will proceed to do a marvelous work among this people, even a marvelous work and a wonder. For the wisdom of their wise men shall perish, and the understanding of their prudent men shall be hid. Woe unto them that seek deep to hide their counsel from the Lord, and their works are in the dark, and they say, Who seeth us? And who knoweth us? Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay. For shall the work say of him that made it, He made me not? Or shall the thing framed say of him that framed it, He had no understanding? Is it not yet a very little while, and Lebanon shall be turned into a fruitful field? And the fruitful field shall be esteemed as a forest? And in that day shall the deaf hear the words of the book, and the eyes of the blind shall see out of obscurity and out of darkness. The meek also shall increase their joy in the Lord, and the poor among men shall rejoice in the Holy One of Israel. For the terrible one is brought to naught, and the scorner is consumed, and all that watch for iniquity are cut off, that make a man an offender for a word, and lay a snare for him that reproveth in the gate, and turn aside the just for a thing of naught. Therefore thus saith the Lord, who redeemed Abraham, concerning the house of Jacob, Jacob shall not now be ashamed, neither shall his face now wax pale. But when he seeth his children, the work of mine hands in the midst of him, they shall sanctify my name, and sanctify the Holy One of Jacob, and shall fear the God of Israel. They also that erred in spirit shall come to understanding, and they that murmured shall learn doctrine.
All right, so let me break some down for you. So this is talking about the Bible itself, the scroll. And the vision of all has become as few words of a book, a scroll that is sealed. I'm going to prove that to you. See, the Lord told me, I've opened the scroll. I'm giving it to you, Jonathan. And I did that a long time ago. I said, the Lord said, here, I've opened the scroll. Jesus has his spirit opened the scroll. And he said, here you go, Jonathan. You're the guy. You're going to deliver this. I was like, I will do as you ask. Everything you tell me, I'll do. Now watch this. Let me show you something. And the book is delivered to him. Watch. And the vision of all, the vision, the look, the revelation or compact agreement, notable vision, has become unto you as the words of a book that is sealed. It's the scroll. It's talking about the Bible. And if you deliver it to someone that is learning, saying, read this, I pray thee, he'll say, I cannot, for it is sealed. It is closed up, sealed up. And you deliver to him that is not learned, and you say, read this, I pray thee, and you say, I am not learned. Wherefore the Lord says, for as much as this people draw near to me with their mouth, that's lip service, guys, and with their lips they do honor me, but they have removed their heart far from me, and their fear of me is taught by the precept of men. Therefore, behold, I will proceed to do a marvelous work, even a marvelous work and a wonder among this people, for the wisdom of their wise men shall perish, and the understanding of their prudent men shall be hidden. Then it says, woe unto them that seek deep to hide their counsel from the Lord, and their works are in the dark. And they say, who seeth us, and who knoweth us? Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay. Genesis 2, what the Lord God formed. And the Lord God formed his man as a potter, from the dust, from the clay. Okay, this is Christ. This is man as Christ's representative. I'll prove it. 1 Corinthians 15. So this is Christ's representative. Here you go. And so it is written, the first man, Adam. Look, Adam. Adam. Hebrew word. This is Greek. It's from Hebrew word 121. See it right there? 121, Adam, the first man of Jesus as his representative, the first man, Adam, watch, as Christ's representative, Genesis 2. Here it is. You don't even see the word, the name Adam, 121 into Genesis 2. There it is. And he brought him to Adam. Adam, Hebrew word 121, told you. So, Surely you're turning of things upside down because you're in their system. We got turned upside down and backwards in the host body system. That's why you're their slave. But when you flip it, you can see everything and you're no longer the slave. You become their master. That's why they hate us, because we turn to L. So when we get converted in the system we call the earth, we get Emmanuel with us as El, the Almighty God. That's why Jacob becomes Yisrael. Watch this. I'll prove it. Prove it all day long now. Ready? Isaiah. Isaiah 43. He's saying, look, he said, but now thus saith the Lord that created thee, O Jacob. Look what Jacob means. That means heel catcher, supplanter, because he was a twin, Esau and Jacob. So think of twins, right side up and upside down. Supplanter, that means one that takes over. Well, yeah, I don't know if everybody knows this, but Jacob wrestled with the angel of the Lord till dawn, and the Lord smited him on the leg. He's like, and Jacob's like, I'm not going to let go. I'm not letting go of you. And then the angel of the Lord said, who are you? You don't think God knew his name? He wanted him to admit who he was and what he had done. So he said, well, who are you? And he says, I'm Jacob. And the Lord says, because you have admitted who you are, I will bless you. All we have to do is admit who we are and what we've done, and we'll turn from Jacob to Israel. Because, see, the Lord God renames him right there. He goes, okay, you're no longer Jacob, you're Israel. I'm going to rename. So Jacob becomes Israel. You know what Israel means, right? He will rule as El. So look, so the Lord God that created thee, O Jacob, supplanter, because we are all Jacob. We supplant the system when we get converted. O Jacob that formed thee, look, formed thee, Yatsar, as a potter, see it? And that formed thee, O Israel, he will rule as God, but the word God is El, see? Yisra-El. See, Yisra, right there, Yisra, E-L. El is Hebrew word for 10. See, E-L, what's El? It's the Almighty God. From the root 352, a ram from its strength, a sheep. And they hate God. They hate God. Those that make idols hate God. El. Jesus is Emmanuel. With us is El, the Almighty God. I'll prove it. Watch. Again. So I'll just prove it all day long now, man. The Lord gave me the keys to the kingdom. It's like, dude, this is crazy. Isaiah 7. Therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and you shall call his name Emmanuel. Okay, Emmanu means with us is, see, Emmanu right there. I colored it all yellow, Emmanu. And then EL, I colored green because EL is Hebrew word for 10. That's why I colored it green here. Watch, Hebrew word for 10 is EL. El, the Almighty God. See, now let's go back. Emmanu means with us is. And then, you know what, I'm gonna change this to green, right? I'm going to change this part to green. With us is El, the Almighty God. I'm going to keep it the same color. There you go. So see, look, Emmanu means with us is. And then, see, E-L is Hebrew word for 10, El, the Almighty God. See, E-L, Hebrew word for 10. Who's El? The Almighty God. So that's why they hate Jesus in this system, because he comes in and flips us and we supplant their entire world and we become, he will rule as El. We get turned from Jacob to Israel, all of us, cumulatively. Now watch this. Back to Isaiah 43. Here we go. Isaiah 43. Now watch this. Fear not, I've created thee, O Jacob, created thee, heel catcher, a supplanter, because he's a twin, he's going to supplant the system, and that formed thee through the idea of squeezing into shape as a potter. That's the same word as Genesis 2, that formed Adam. O Yisrael, he will rule as El, the Almighty God. Fear not, for I have redeemed thee. I have redeemed thee. You know, to buy back, it's like to buy back a relative's property. Look, there it is. To buy back a relative's property. I have redeemed thee. I've called thee by thy name. An appellation, Jonathan Kleck, means Yahweh has given a messenger that rings the bell. When thou passest through, when you cross over to the other side, look, specifically in copulation. See it right there? When thou passest through, when you cross over in copulation to the other side through the semen, I will be with you. I told you. That's why the largest altar in the world is a big dead sheep melting and a bunch of angels melting into semen. Let's look at it. Let's just knock it out of the park, man. We got it, guys. This is the mystery of all of it. Soft. And then I'm going to show you today how the Lord God showed me absolutely the race is almost over. And y'all are about to cross the finish line. Ready? Here we go. So here we go. There is a big snake wearing a crown, divining serpent. There is a Vatican, means divining serpent. Divining makes meaning, you know, things happen according to your will. So here is the divining serpent. Okay, the mouth of that serpent. Let's see. Let me go right here. I want to show it to you from both sides. I'm sorry. I'm really excited, guys. Okay, watch this. I'll show it to you from this side and this side. I'll put this one right next to it. Okay, so here we go. Watch. So there you go. So there's, see, there's the big keyhole. We got turned upside down. We are the cross. So the cross goes in the lock, gets turned upside down. Now the door is locked, and the locked door becomes the serpent. So the locked door that we're in becomes a serpent. The mouth right there of the snake wearing the crown, that is this window right here. So that window right there is that mouth right there. So what I'm going to do is I'll just drag this out of that folder, and I'll take the window of the sheep and put it right there in the mouth. That's the mouth of the serpent right there. What's the mouth of the serpent? It's a vagina. So what's going into the vagina? See the seat? That's a penis. Oh, when thou crossest through to the other side, through copulation in semen, I will be with you. What's going through there? A bunch of angels melting into semen. Told ya. This is the greatest gift there is on the planet. You get it? I am. 1969. So in their system, the word of God endures forever. It's perfection. It's literally perfection, even the numbers. So God proves that he exists in their system by turning everything up and then taking over the system, and they freak out. That's why they hate us. Those that hate me make host bodies. I told you. It's because he has to come in and redeem his children, buy them back on a cross. And I'm sure that's no fun. Yeah. Anyway, real serious for a second, but there it is. So now you know why this whole thing's a penis, and now you know why a bunch of angels are melting into semen. Isaiah 43. When thou passest through to cross over to the other side in copulation, which is sex, to the other side to alienate, it means also alienate, when you pass through, to cross over to the other side in copulation through the semen, I will be with thee. What do you think you're looking at right here? A bunch of angels crossing through to the other side in semen. There it is. You're looking at it. You're looking at an exact altar carved representation of Isaiah 43. When you, who? God's angels, crosses through, pass over to the other side in copulation through the water, semen. Don't worry, I'll be with you. I'll come get you. Dude, okay. Okay, so there's the sheep. There's the sheep. There's the whole, look, the whole altar is a dead sheep. There it is. The whole thing's a dead sheep. And It's right side up male. You turn the whole sheep upside down. And so I'll take the sheep right here and I'll take it and I'll put it right here and turn it upside down. And it becomes the female reproductive system. And there you go, male and female. Let us create the male and female. In the vain show of Elohim created he him, male and female created he them. Don't worry when you cross over to the other side in copulation, fear not, I will be with thee. This is the greatest mystery ever solved. It's like, woohoo! I am 1961. Told ya. So inside you, you gotta take that and flip it. Flip it. No more Satan. You cut the cord to the pit. You cut the cord to the pit. You get flipped up. There's two ups and you're good to go. Your eyes have become single. Okay, now I'm going to show you how the Lord God showed me you're about to cross the finish line. You ready? Y'all want to see that? I'm going to try and do this as nicely as I can, but anyone that thinks I'm wearing a hat and it's got some checkers on it makes me Illuminati. You are a Nimrod. And that's a nice way of telling you you're brain dead and you're not functioning. Because all I'm doing is exposing the enemy's kingdom and pouring forth more truth than most people have ever even imagined seeing, hearing, or getting to know. So if you're going to look at these little dots up here and you go, oh, Clark's Illuminati because he's got... No, it's a finish line. See, V for vengeance in the middle of my hat, right side up and upside down. V for vengeance, because he's going to take vengeance on that system, and it makes an X, which is female chromosome. So now, I'm wearing my V for vengeance hat. That represents a finish line, like a race. Well, now let me show you what Vatican means so you see it with your own eyes. A lot of people are like, oh, no, it doesn't. Yeah, it does. Let's see. Divining servant. Let's see. Vatican. Where'd he go? Here you go. Does the name Vatican mean divining serpent? Here's Maggie Erickson, pastor, Bible scholar, and teacher. She probably doesn't know the truth, though. Christian counselor of 50 years. The word Vatican means divining serpent. The word Vatican literally means divining serpent. Now, I could show this to you, I can go look it up 20 other ways. I just grabbed this one because it's highlighted. Divining serpent is derived from Vatis equals diviner and can equal sermon, and Vatican City and St. Peter's Basilica were built on ancient pagan site called, in Latin, Vaticanus Mons, or Vaticanus Colus, which means hill or mountain of prophecy. Okay, well, the word divining means to foretell, to predict, to prophesy, to forecast, to foresee, or to prognosticate, and to have supernatural or magical insight into future events. Okay. Why do you think all the bombings are printed on the U.S. currency? Okay, let's do a quick scan of that real quick. Let me show you just a quick U.S. currency thing. All right, grabbed a quick cup of coffee and here we go. So here is a picture of the Vatican, divining serpent. Divining serpent means basically the serpent that makes the future happen according to its own will. So if we go to, let me just shut a couple windows. I got some super cool stuff to show you guys right now. So make sure you stay for the rest of this video. You're not going to want to miss it. Okay, so I'm going to go to my Welcome to the World of Good and Evil, and then I'll do the U.S. currency folder. There we go. Where the Lord let me break down all the U.S. currency back in 2003. I was showing people stuff that on the U.S. currency, they had absolutely no clue whatsoever what was going on. So here is the Twin Towers. I have taken the Twin Tower and clearly identified on the U.S. currency the explosions in the exact locations, even on the money itself. So there's a Twin Tower on the $20 bill. There's a Twin Towers. Let me Let me kind of scroll down to get you guys to. Okay, there you go. There's the federal building bombing in Oklahoma City. There's a federal building blown up. That's on the old 20. They took it out of circulation. These bills are hard to find, but here's a picture of the front of the bill. There's the back of the bill. This bill right here turns into the federal building bombing blowing up. It is identical. There's three layers of ink. I isolated those three layers of ink. There they are. There's the building blowing up right there. That is the federal building bombing. Same number of long rectangular windows. Then when you turn the bill over, this image right here shows the building blown in half. And I lined the building up right here. There's part of the building. Here's the other part. You can see the floors sticking out here and here, just like there, 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 and there. There's the side of the building, side of the building, floor, 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 other side of the building, other side of the building, floor sticking out, explosion. So this has been clearly identified. I did this back in 2002. Even the rounded edges of the building match identically to the side of the building right here. So that was the federal building bombing in Oklahoma City. Here are the Twin Towers matched up and laid right on top. So I took the U.S. currency, put it right on top. When you take any one of these currency notes and you have folded it in the shape of a pentagram, that's when it reveals the image. Because this is the divine, the serpent's kingdom, this upside down star that represents his kingdom, a star which is an angel that's been turned upside down. So when you draw around the perimeter of this bill and you connect the vertices, you get this, and that is the sigil of Baphomet. Let me just do a quick Google image. Star of Satan. Star of Satan, there you go. Right there. U.S. currency, sigil of Baphomet. There's a goat right in the middle. I'll pop it right into there. Bam, there it is. See, so in order to see what their divine, you know, this is making the future happen according to your will. So in this system, the serpent, the divining serpent, is printing the bombings on all the U.S. currency. Now watch. So even bombings that are coming, by the way, there's the Pentagon right here on the back of the Twin Tower bill. There's the Pentagon blowing up. The Lord let me find that. No one knew the Pentagon was there. That was the Lord revealing it to Jonathan Kleck. There it is right there. And there's the actual Pentagon. I've matched them up. I've laid them on top of each other. From here to here, I've lined them up. They are identical. Then the Lord gave me a prophetic utterance. He told me to take the new currency, the $10 bill, and fold it the same way. It's a tidal wave coming over a seven-story building. He gave me a prophetic utterance before Barack Obama became president. Behold, the hand of the oppressor has been lifted against you, and out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind. Water as high as the walls of Jerusalem will cover the city by the sea. There's the new $10 bill. There's a tidal wave coming over a seven-story building. I had no idea how high the walls of Jerusalem were. But there it is, a tidal wave coming over a seven-story building. Who's doing it? The sigil of Baphomet, the goat. Who are the goats? The serpent race. There you go. Here's the new $100 bill. It came out, fire and smoke and a devouring wind. There is New York. I'm going to put this back where it go. I'm going to put this back with the Star of Satan. There is, let's see, the U.S. currency. There is the $100 bill right here, and there's three layers of ink, and it shows New York being destroyed by a devouring wind and water right here. There it is. And I just superimpose it over the movie the day after. If you don't believe me, stick around for 30 seconds and I'll pull up the video. Here's a prophetic utterance the Lord gave me in 2008.
Against you, and out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind. Water as high as the walls of Jerusalem shall cover the city by the sea, and great shall be the destruction of that city.
Here is the new $100 bill. The 10 has been turned upside down. Anyone that watches my ministry should know what that means. Here come contrails of missiles right here.
I'm going to just kind of fast forward it here so you can get to it. Now, here are the layers of ink are. Here is the divining serpent showing that it's going to destroy New York by printing the destruction of New York City on the $100 bill.
Directional lines. There's darker ink in certain spots. You'll see it. Okay, these unidirectional lines is movement towards the subject, which is us. As I change the magnification, you're going to see all of this is going to turn to waves coming in from those nukes that went down, and they're going to be destroying the city. Watch. Here it goes. There it is. See it? See how it changed?
I mean, look at that. That's one layer of ink. Now watch.
See how it gets all fluffy?
There's another layer of ink. Now watch.
Boom.
Out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind. I mean, you're looking at it. Printed on the money. Then the $10 bill, they made a tidal wave coming over a 7-story building. I had no idea when I prophesied that, you know, the walls of Jerusalem in some places are like 72 feet. It just happens to be that the building on the $10 bill is a 7-story building. That's convenient. That's about 70 feet. Walls of Jerusalem. Water as high as the walls of Jerusalem, 70 feet. Tidal wave. Devouring wind, nuke. It's on the money because the divining serpent, that's the angel of the bottomless pit that's running the scorpion race above ground, he's making things happen according to his will, using all the little puppets to make all the bills and to make all the hidden stuff, because he's the whole system is meant to destroy God's angels. That's why he said, I will rise above the stars of the Most High. The word stars means princes of El. I told you. Here we go.
There it is. Buildings being wiped out. There it is. See the water? That's water. I'm going to go back. Look. There it is. Now picture the water coming at you. Boom. Boom.
Look at that.
Now picture the water coming at you. Boom, 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 boom. Devastation. Let me show
you. There it is. Okay, so now I wanted to show you guys. Now, see, that's why Vatican means divining serpent, because the serpent race that's being run by the pit, the angel of Obama's pit's making everything happen, thinking he's got it all going, but then all of a sudden, the Lord God's going to flip it, and we've been supplanting the system the entire time. We're the supplanters. We're Jacob, and we become Yisrael. Got it. All right. Now, let's see. Where are we going next? Okay. Boom, boom, boom. Okay, here we go. Now, get ready. Here we go. Now, y'all remember, let's do the Heineken commercial. This is the divining serpent doing a commercial right here. Watch. Okay, now he rings the bell, and then they specifically make sure the group of guys that he's from is playing a piano. Ding, ding. Well, it changes the very sound, and then there's a bell, and then he reacts to a different noise. So the word Cain in the Bible, the word Cain for like Cain and Abel, means to strike a musical note. Because all of a sudden he's hearing a different noise. He's not hearing from the Lord God, because you have radio interference in your head from the other race, from that other entity. Good and evil now mixed into one system. you're getting radio interference. Now he's going to go into this party. Watch. See the number six? See? They did it right there. They changed the sound. Listen. Now, they're playing bird because the Bible says, and the birds of the air come and nest in it. The host body system. And they hate us. Okay, let's see what's... Now, here you go. Now, there's an 11 behind him. He went into the number 6. By the way, in the Bible, the number 6 is Abel. You know, like Cain and Abel. That's why the sound changed. Watch, you know, everything I say, I'm going to prove to you. That's why the sound changed as soon as... Okay, now, then he turned... Sorry. Then he turned it upside down. The 6 went to a 9. Okay, 6 goes to a 9. Okay, now I'm going to show you the way the Lord's showing me the finish lines, right? We're about to cross the finish line. I'm about to go ring that bell, folks. Watch this. Okay. So the 6 turns to a 9, and that's 9-11. And 9-11 is the angel of the bottomless pit. Okay, ready? 9-11, and they had a king over them. Who did? They had tails, they, look, and they had tails like unto, and I'm going to highlight yellow, and they had a king over them, and his name is Apollyon, Satan, the destroyer. So Apollyon is Satan, Abaddon is Satan. So Hebrew tongue is G3. They use the G. It's the number 3, a destroying angel, Abaddon. So destruction. So now the number 6, Genesis 4, and she names him Abel. Hebel, watch. Let me type this into Google for you. Sorry, hang on one second. Strong's. Strong 6 is Abel, son of Adam. See? So, the number 6 is Abel, the son of Adam. Okay? The second son of Adam and Eve, the brother of Cain. He's the twin of Cain. So, now watch. Let's see. Where'd I go? Okay, so, he went into the flesh party. He gets thrown out, and he's all dirtied up now. And now it's time for your judgment. The number 11 means destruction, place of destruction. 9-11, angel of the bottomless pit. Sorry, I thought I'd switched it already. Angel of the bottomless pit, Revelation 9. See, 9-11 right there. That's why he's doing that. That's why he's doing that. Okay, so he went from 6, he went from the son of Adam, the number 6, and then to 9-11, they had a king over them, that is Satan, the destroyer, because he went into the flesh party, he got all dirtied up, and so now 9-11 has legal deed, legal right to destroy him, and unless you get converted, that's why he's flipping it upside down. Because now he's in trouble. So there it is. So there he is, dancing with the girl in scarlet. There you go. And that's why it shows us red star right there, because that represents one of God's angels that went into the flesh party and got destroyed. Okay, now it's time for the Daytona 500. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to close out the Vatican. I'm going to drop some of these windows. We don't need them all anymore. Let's see. I'll say that in case we need it. Heineken. Here we go. Daytona 500. Now, this was like the very last lap. The number 11 car, or the number 6 car was in the lead. And then I'm gonna do this and I'm gonna change the and then I'm gonna turn the volume all the way off, and then I'll show you just real quick shots. So the 6 car is in the lead, and then it gets flipped. So there it goes. I just don't want to do too much. Let's see, hang on. So there he goes into the wall. So there's the 6 car. Now see, the divining serpent can't orchestrate what you're looking at. The divining serpent can orchestrate the U.S. currency. The divining serpent can do a Heineken commercial and mock all God's angels, but the divining serpent can't do what you're looking at. You got the number 6, which represents Abel in the Bible. 6 is Abel. And now it's getting turned upside down and backwards. And the number 11 crosses the finish line in first place. And then the number that was 6 turns upside down to 9 and slides across the finish line in 9th place. 9, 11. And the 6 got turned upside down to a 9, crossing the finish line. Oh, kind of like Jonathan's hat. Hang on one sec. Okay, hang on. Let's see, let me make sure this is still working. Yeah, it's working. Okay, so let me see. The divining serpent can do all this. The divining serpent can hide the bombings on the U.S. currency.
Exploding. The reason
it can have his little group of scorpion race make these plates because the divining serpent is running the human race as a like a queen ant running all the other ants. But the divining serpent cannot do what happened at the Daytona 500. Now let me show you the symbology. Watch this. Now you know that Donald Trump, let's see, I'm gonna knock out some stuff here. I'll knock that out. Okay, so there it is. The car's flipping. The number 6 is turning upside down to 9. The number 11 wins the race. Okay, let's see. Now this is, here we go. Let me show you what's going on. So here we go. So in the final turn of the race, Newman. Wow, Newman, like Newman 6. Gets turned upside down, pulled right up to Newman's bumper, the trouble began. So then the 6 gets flipped upside down and turns backwards. There it is, going backwards. It's going backwards. Then it flips upside down. The 6 becomes a 9. Number 11 crosses the finish line and wins. Number 6 becomes a 9. Crosses in 9th place. So 9-11 crosses, these two cross the finish line. This meant 6 is able, but now it's 9. 9 means judgment, and 11 means destruction. And it crosses the finish line, and it crosses as 9-11, the finish line, at the Daytona 500. Let me show you what 500 means. Five hundred means Antichrist. There you go. Now, I don't know if you guys know this, but Donald Trump took a lap, and by the way, Barack Obama's the Antichrist. Okay, so Trump takes a lap at Daytona in the Beast. Okay, so Donald Trump takes a lap in the Beast around the Daytona 500. So Donald Trump takes the Beast around the Daytona 500 because the limousine that he went around the track in was actually during Barack Obama's presidency. That limousine came into service and they called it the Beast. So Barack Obama used to ride around in the Beast. Well, that same limousine carried over into Donald Trump's term, and it's called the Beast. And so the Beast took a lap around the Daytona 500. 500 means Antichrist. And the number 6 turned upside down to a 9, crossed the finish line in 9th place, with number 11 winning. Number 11 means destruction. Abaddon, watch. This is unbelievable. So yeah, so this is the Lord God, by the way, crossing the finish line. Get it? Place of destruction. See, Abaddon, the place of destruction or ruin. That was orchestrated by the Lord God, not the divining serpent. The Lord God is the one that was in control of what happened in that race. Get it? Crossing the finish line. Told you it's coming. That's a heads up from the Lord God himself. Abel gets flipped to destruction, same as the Heineken commercial, from 6 to 9. 11 crosses the finish line, just like the door behind the guy in the Heineken commercial. Told you. That's the Lord God, though. Victory! The two have become one. All right, guys. I got more. There's lots more. group hug. I love you guys. Yep, group hug. Okay, everything's going to be all right. If you're in Christ, you should be ecstatic right now. 1691, you got to be kidding me. I exist. Same as 1 Corinthians 2. We do not stand. I exist in the power of men or in the wisdom of men, but in the wisdom of God. That's it. Told you. 100% nylon. So I feel sorry for those guys. All right, there it is, guys. So there's no arguing with all this stuff. There it is. It's coming, man. So that's why they printed all the bombings on the money. So it's all going to roll out just like I told you it's going to roll out. The Hoover Dam's going to get blown up, guaranteed. That'll kill the water systems for California. They're going to bring the system down. The whole coronavirus thing, there's more. You know, I could show you more coronavirus stuff about the general you know what? Let me see real quick. So I started scanning through my stuff. So on second thought, I'm not going to go into the whole coronavirus. You guys know they're rolling it out. I'll post some links, like maybe in the next video or maybe on this video. Just look in the description, and I'll put a letter from one of their generals in 2005. A friend of mine, Michael, sent it to me, and the general just stating to their security council or whatever that in order for the Chinese people to survive, they have to branch out and take over other lands. And this would be best accomplished by infecting their own population with a virus that spreads to America, leaving the infrastructure intact so they could spread out and take over Australia, Canada, and the United States by leaving the buildings intact without nuking them and all this other stuff. So anyway, it's just more of the same. Anyway, I'll post the link, but I don't want to go over it all. It's a no-brainer at this point. They're trying to roll it out. Of course, they'll come up with a vaccine. You'll have to take the mark of the beast to get the vaccine. They're starting to say from the World Health Organization that they want to do away with actual currency notes, you know, like paper money, because of, you know, diseases passed because you're passing money and it's on the money. So now you'd have to go to all digital currency. You know, they're just rolling out the end of the Bible. It already told us what was going to happen. because the Lord God knew everything. So I think we're getting ready to cross the finish line. Isn't that just amazing? By the way, thank you guys for the people that left in the comment section on the last video, the Daytona 500. I was like, yep, what? I'm like, no way. And then I went and watched it. I'm like, that's the Lord God. That's the Lord God giving everybody a heads up. 9/11 crossing the finish line. Abel got flipped. Destruction. We're at the finish line. Now, see, the divining serpent cannot orchestrate that. Pretty cool, huh? All right, guys. All right. Everybody take a deep breath. It's going to be okay. If you're in Christ, you've been turned up. You've been born again. You're just waiting to get your inheritance. That's all. And the way you get it is your body falls to the ground. Then you get it. Amen. All right, guys. Peace and grace.